Hello students, in previous two videos we have discussed about important concept and the plot development of the story, how the story develops. In that we have focused on some characters, in that especially the character of Peddler we have focused. Then character of Crofter we have focused. And in today's video, we will more focus on the character of Tyne Master, Valet and Edla Wilmanson. Slowly, slowly here, author is trying to introduce new characters. And in that, some important characters will be introduced in the next plot development of the story. So here, the Ramshaw Ironworks, which are now closed down, were not so long ago a large plant with smelter, rolling mill and forge. In the summer time, long lines of heavily loaded barge and screws slide down the canal, which led to a large inlet lake. And in the winter time, the roads near the mill were black from all the coal dust which sifted down from the big Carroll crates. So here in this passage, what here author is mentioning about the iron mill and related concern, some important terminologies in that forge, then rolling mills, the smelter, means whatever it is there in the mill, especially the iron mill. Here author is focusing on that. So it is just descriptive. Then during one of the long dark evening, just before Christmas, and now here again the reference of the Christmas it is given, the master smith and his helper, means here that master smith is the blacksmith, and his helper sat in the dark forge near the furnace waiting for pig iron. So here pig iron means the crude iron, we can say to that it is a crude iron also, which had been put in the fire and to be ready to put on the anvil. So if you will search for the anvil, you will understand on that object they are processing the iron. So here every now and then one of them got up and stirred the glowing mass with a long iron bar, returning in few moments dripping and perspiration, though as was the custom he wore nothing but a long shirt and pair of wooden shoes. And now here author is describing about the condition and the atmosphere in that iron mill. And here one character, it is minor character, it is introduced, that is Master Smith and his helpers and the condition of that iron mill. So now we have to focus again about the important thing. In this passage also author is talking about the iron mill and all the nearby that resources, especially the furnace. You can observe the condition in that furnace, how would be, and how the other all helpers they would help. And what is the thing here, one more concept it is mentioned, that is pig iron, that is crude iron, and then they will make the process from that. Then now all the time there were many sounds to be heard in the forge. And earlier there was a reference in the beginning of the page number 35 that the peddler, he was thinking that now nothing would happen, but suddenly he observed suddenly he heard the sounds, and here, but just as he laid his head on the ground, he heard a sound, a hard, regular thumping. There was no doubt as what that was. He raised himself, though those are the hammer strokes from an iron mill. So here it is clearly mentioned, and now again that sound reference here we can get. So what is that? All the time there were many sounds to be heard in the forge. The big bellows groaned. So now here, what type of sounds and which instrument it is creating that sound? It is mentioned here. Big bellows groaned and burning coil cracked. The fire boy shoveled charcoal into the maw of furnace. Maw of furnace means it is the place where we are keeping all the things, and then for the burning especially, means it is a kind of process. Maw means it is like a mouth we can observe, and we are all putting. So once you will prefer the picture of that maw of the furnace, you will get clear. Then with a great deal of clatter, outside roar the waterfall, and a sharp north wind whiffed the rain against the brick tiled roof. So here one more again scenery, that description. What is here, one more focus it is given on waterfall, means outside roared the waterfall, and outside that the sound of the waterfall also, and it is like a roaring sound, fast, and sharp north wind, and that wind also sound, the whiff the rain against the brick tiled roof. So condition here it is mentioned, and in that condition especially in the month of here December also mentioned, it was probably an account of all this noise that the blacksmith didn't notice the man. Now here actually means in three passages, author just focus on the iron mill, then inside what was there, and then condition, and some other also equipments, whatever it was there, and especially he was trying to focus on the sound. It was probably an account of all this noise that the blacksmith didn't notice that the man had opened the gate and entered the forge until he stood close up to the furnace. And this peddler, he entered without permission, and it was not noticed by the blacksmith. So here now the process will begin, the process of investigating this person or understanding this peddler. It was probably an account of all this noise that the blacksmith did not notice that the man had opened the gate and entered the forge. And this peddler opened the gate and entered in that. What was the basic thing? If he would be there, he could warm his body and he would get the shelter for night. That was his purpose, why the peddler was there, to save his life, to survive in that critical situation. Surely it was nothing unusual for poor vagabond without any better shelter for the night to be attracted to the forge by the glow of light which escaped through the soothy pans. So here, and to come into warm themselves in front of the fire. So here it is here clearly mentioned that what was the purpose or motive of that peddler to be there. He was thief, we can understand, but then also now his purpose was different. He was there especially to survive in that condition. Surely it was nothing unusual for poor vagabond without any better shelter for the night to be attracted to the forge by glow of light which escaped through the soothy pan, and one more thing, to come into warm themselves in front of the fire. Because of the December, there would be a very cool breeze and atmosphere Because of that, he was there. Blacksmith glanced only casually and indifferently at the intruder. So here intruder means a person who intrudes, especially into building with criminal intention. So here he means blacksmith started thinking about that person, that the person who might be the thief, or that person entered without permission, and that person it is there not without speaking. If someone would be there, then there may be the, here we can call that person as a trespasser, as an intruder, means without permission somebody would enter in your place, and the intention specially may be the criminal intention. Like that here we can think. He looked the way people of his type usually did, with a long beard, dirty, ragged, and with a bunch of rat traps dangling on his chest. And here author is describing the character of peddler, physical here description. So you have to note when there would be character sketch would be asked, so you can write that. So how was the peddler? He looked the way of the people his type usually did, with long beard, dirty, ragged. So all the words here author is using about the peddler, and with a bunch of rat traps dangling on his chest. So here dangling on his chest, dangling here moving, we can think about that, or hanging, swinging loosely, that is the word dangling we can use. He asked permission to stay, and the master blacksmith nodded a haughty consent, means arrogantly superior or disdainful, such type of, without honoring him with a single word. And he nodded that consent, but it was not with the respect. And earlier also it was discussed about the peddler, that the whole world for him, it was like a problem for him. Why? Because there was no respect on behalf of the society people. So he was thinking lonely, and his thinking about the world, it was also changed. Then again one more thing here we can think about, and what is that important thing? The tramp did not say anything. So this tramp, he was not saying anything. Actually, suppose you wish to enter anywhere, then first you will speak, you will ask for the permission, and if you will go there, if someone is speaking to you or observing you, immediately you will react. But here we are observing the different thing, and in that, what is the observation? The tramp did not say anything either. He had not come there to talk, but only to warm himself and sleep. So here the purpose of entering in that iron mill, especially what was the purpose? Here it is. He had not come there to talk, but only to warm himself and sleep. And if he would warm himself and he would get the sleep and means the shelter, that was enough for this type of vagabond person. Because vagabond person, they are wandering from one place to another place, from one village to another village. Means there is no fixed place for them that they would leave. So like that, it is their daily routine. So for him, what was the intention? Just intention to warm his body, and one more intention to sleep. Then in those days, the Ramsjob iron mill was owned by very prominent iron master. So here prominent iron masters, the mills were there, it is here, whose greatest ambition was to ship out good iron to the market. And here the market value, then the standard of the standard quality of the iron. So all that here it is means quality product. He watched both night and the day to see that the work was done as well as possible. And at this very moment, means he used to closely observe the work. He means here especially the iron masters, they used to pay attention in such type of work. So the workers and the officers, whoever is there, they should work efficiently. Then one more again here, at this very moment, he came into the forge, one of his nightly round of inspection, and he was there for the round. Means suppose at night sometime workers may not work properly because owner is not there. So here for night also sometime they may visit and they may inspect that how the workers they are doing and how the mill it is, the iron mill, it, the all functioning, how it is going on. Naturally, the first thing he saw was the tall ragamuffin who had eased his way so close to the furnace that steam rose from his weight rags. The iron master did not follow the example of the blacksmith who had hardly deigned to him over very carefully, then tore off his slouch hat to get a better view of his face. So here iron master, as a owner, whenever you are owner, your aspects, your views and the way of dealing with the things would be totally different. So as like a owner, now he is behaving here. And what is that? He walked close up to him, looked him over very carefully, and he observed that person very carefully, then tore off his slouch hat to get a better view of his face. And then he observed that how is that person, how that person looks like, and he confirmed who is that person. So that confirmation, it is very important. But there was a misconception about that person, and because of that misconception we can observe. So here again new character, but of course it is you, Nels Olof. So here this person was the old acquaintance of iron master. So but this was the misconception. Actually in reality that he was not the Nels Olof, but he was the peddler, rat trap peddler, rat trap seller. How you do look means in that atmosphere, and how was his behavior and physical appearance, it is like with long beard, dirty, ragged, and with bunch of rat trap dangling on his chest. So like that image, like that here the physical appearance, it is there. And this iron master started thinking about that person. He is Nels Olof. The man with the rat strap had never before seen the iron master at Ramshoe and did not even know what his name was. But it occurred to him that if the fine gentleman thought he was an old acquaintance, he might perhaps throw him a couple of kroner. Therefore, he did not want to undeceive him at all at once. So here if someone is saying that you are the Nels Olof, at least here he should say that I am not that person. But sometime the silence may do better for you. So here he kept mum and he is not reacting to the person. But afterwards again there would be problem. Suppose one false thing you will prefer Then next again false things you have to say. And then one day it would come that you may fall into such type of trap. Yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me, he said. And here, what is the expression? Yes, God knows things have gone downhill with me, he said. You should not have resigned from the regiment. So a regiment means the military regiment, said the iron master. That was the mistake. If only I had still been in the service at the time, it never would have happened. And again, it is about the if you would be in the service, it may not happen such type of thing. Well, now of course, you will come home with me. And now here Iron Master is again requesting. What is the request of the Iron Master? That is the genuine request. Suppose you will find your old acquaintance or the friend in such type of condition, then what will happen? You will not think about that person in negative way. What you will think? You will think in a positive way. I have to help because now you are the owner of the mill, you have money, and you can do something for your friend. And in history also, or in literature also, you might be reading such type of thing. And there is a famous example of Lord Krishna and Sudama in friendship. Means, suppose such type of person would be there, the old acquaintance or the friend, and if he would be in such type of condition, then it is the duty of the friend to offer him the shelter. And the same thing here we are observing in the Iron Masters. Behavior, okay, Iron Master's character. So one more again here to go along of to the manor house. Manor house means here the Iron Master's house, and be received by the owner like an old regimental comrade. And he was not a person like this, any common person, old regimental comrade. Old regimental means here military friend, means he was also there. And you can understand, suppose you will cheat any military person, you can observe their anger and their discipline. If they, means if the Iron Master will understand that he is not the Nils Olof or the captain of that team, afterwards it is mentioned as a captain. So here, then what he will do with him? He may give that peddler to the police, or he himself may again beat, or something else he may do with that person. That, however, did not please the tramp, and because of that, the offer, it was the offer from the Iron Master, but it was now this peddler is in the dilemma whether to accept that offer or not to accept that offer. If he will accept that offer, then he has to prove that he was Nils Olof, or as a captain he worked there. And to behave like a captain, it is not possible because you don't know how to behave. Means as like an educated person, the way how educated people they are behaving, because he was not like that person. No, I couldn't think of it, he said, looking quite alarmed. And here he was now rejecting. No, I couldn't think of it, he said, looking quite alarmed. He thought of the 30 kroner, and suddenly he thought of the 30 kroner money also. To go up to manor house would be like throwing himself voluntarily into lion's den. So here, why the lion's den it is mentioned? Because now when he will go there, and when others will recognize him, or Iron Master will recognize him, then he was imagining that the condition, what will happen next. He only wanted a chance to sleep here in the forge and then sneak away as inconspicuously as possible. So here What was the again important thing? His motive was only to sleep there for a night, and he was getting the very good shelter there. So here only one important thing he was thinking. He was thinking only about to warm his body, but not to go in the manor house or the iron master's house. So this was the intention of the peddler. But here iron master was thinking differently, because he was thinking about the Nils Olaf as a friend. So iron master would again urge any friend. Iron master may be thinking, because of his condition he is denying. Because he was not in good condition, he was denying to come to the house. And that was the natural expression from the iron master, we can observe. The iron master assumed that he felt embarrassed because of his miserable clothing. And why he is embarrassed to come there? Because of the miserable clothing. But we can change that. So like that here, iron master is thinking. Please don't think that I have such a fine home that you cannot show yourself there. So please don't think that I have a very nice home and how you could adjust in such type of costume or the miserable clothing. He said Elizabeth is dead, and now he is referring about Elizabeth. Elizabeth is dead, as you may already have heard. Means he was thinking about the old acquaintance, that he knows everything, and in that manner he is speaking about that. My boys are abroad, and boys are also not there, and there is no one at home except my oldest daughter and myself. And now only two people are there in that house. One is iron master and the oldest daughter. So here we can observe one more again important thing, that is loneliness. And what is here it is clearly mentioned. We were just seeing that it was too bad we didn't have any company for Christmas, and he was thinking that we only two are there and we do not have any person for the Christmas. Now come along with me and help us make Christmas food disappear a little faster. And he was thinking that if you would be there, then we can enjoy the Christmas Eve also, and whatever the food we have prepared, it would also be means fast we can finish. So this was the clear, very pure intention of the iron master. But peddler was in dilemma. Peddler was thinking that if he would accept the offer, then again more problem will happen. If he will say no, I am not a Nils Olaf, then again he has to give his own identity. He was not in condition to reveal his identity as a peddler, and he was not saying that I am not a Nils Olaf. So here but the stranger said no and no and again no. So here what was the reply from the stranger? The reply was, here author is specially mentioning the word stranger for the peddler. He was not actually the friend of the iron master, so author is here using the word stranger. But the stranger said no and no and again no, and the iron master saw that he must give in. And iron master saw all that things, and he was thinking that he should come with him. It looks as though Captain Venstel preferred to stay with you tonight. Staying strong, he said to the master blacksmith and turned on his hill. But he laughed to himself as he went away, and the blacksmith, who knew him, understood very well that he had not said his last word. And here Iron Masters, again one more character trait it is mentioned, that he would not think negatively. Again he would say something, or he may plan something more to convince that person. And further it is reflected the same. It was not more than half an hour before they heard the sound of carriage wheels outside the forge, and a new guest came in. So here a new guest came in, and who was that new guest? But this time it was not the Iron Master, and this time he was not the Iron Master but somebody else. And who was that somebody else? He had sent his daughter. Daughter name is not mentioned here. Daughter name is mentioned afterwards. But here the new character, it is introduced as a Iron Master's daughter, apparently hoping that she would have better powers of persuasion than he himself. So here author is trying to focus on new character, and how is that new character? With better persuasion power, better convincing power. So this character will change something. New character, whenever in any play or the story, any person would think about the new character, then that appearance of the new character, entry of the new character, everybody can understand. So here the entry of the new character, it is in the carriage wheels. In that, now one more thing we can understand. She entered followed by a valet, and one more here character, it is of the valet, carrying on his arm a big fur coat. She was not at all pretty, and now author is introducing the character of Iron Master's daughter without mentioning the name. And how is she? She was not at all pretty, but seemed modest and quite shy. She was in appearance, looks modest, but quite shy also. In the forge, everything was just as it had been earlier in the evening. The master blacksmith and his apprentice still sat on their bench, and Iron Master and Karkol still glowed in the furnace. Now here again the new thing, what will happen? The stranger stretched himself out on the floor and lay with a piece of pig iron under his head and his hat pulled down over his eyes. So here with that crude, means pig iron means here crude iron. And now what is the position here? It is mentioned the stretched himself out on the floor, means he was in a position to sleep on the floor and lay with a piece of pig iron under his head and his hat pulled down over his eyes. And he had pulled down the hat on his eyes, and he was in position to sleep. As soon as the young girl caught sight of him, she went up and lifted his hat. Suddenly, if any new character or new person, or especially the girl, would come and take out such type of thing, the man was evidently used here. The man was evidently used to sleeping with one eye open, and he was sleeping in one eye open. The thinking here, we can observe that he was not at all that time he was sleeping. He was just observing that what is. He jumped up abruptly and seemed to be quite frightened. And now he was thinking that somebody recognized him, and he was too much frightened also. He jumped up abruptly, and suddenly abruptly he jumped and seemed to be quite frightened. And now here author introduced the character, that is Edla Wilmanson character. So here this character is very important character for the question also, means in board exam already on this character 2-3 times questions, value based questions also, character based questions also. And the theme, that is transformation, it is also focused in the same character. So here, my name is Edla Wilmanson, said the young girl. My father came home and said that you wanted to sleep here in the forest tonight, and then I asked permission to come and bring you home to us. I am so sorry, Captain, that you are having such a hard time. And here, you know, she is mentioning that peddler as a captain. Captain Von Stanley. And here, she was thinking that now you have such a hard time, and we cannot think that you should sleep here in such type of place in, near the forge. So it is better to come home and sleep there, because you are the old acquaintance of my father. She looked at him compassionately. Compassionate means compassion for any person. And how is that compassion? We can observe that compassionate feelings. We can observe here when you have thought about that person and you are involved in that person in such a way, you are also thinking about the plight of that person, the problems of that person, the unhappiness of that person, you would also involve in such type of atmosphere. She looked at him compassionately with her heavy eyes, and she has started thinking in such a way, and her actions were also different with the heavy eyes. And then she noticed that the man was afraid, and she noticed that the person, he was afraid. Either he has stolen something or else he has escaped from jail. And she observed that person, means peddler, that he was, why that person was too much afraid. If he would be the captain, he may not afraid in such a way. Why he would be frightened? So here two guesses are there. One guess is either he has stolen something. He might have stolen something, so that person is afraid. Or else, he has escaped from jail. She thought and added quickly, "You may be sure, Captain, that you will be allowed to leave us just as freely as you came." So here, one more again important thing you can observe. "You may be sure, Captain, that you will be allowed to leave us just as freely as you came." So here, we will not keep you there in our house for more days. So here, what is the thing? "You may be sure, Captain, that you will be allowed to leave." You can leave as just as freely as you came. "Only please stay with us over Christmas Eve." And there is a, she is here requesting the peddler, requesting that captain. So here she was thinking about that person as a captain and requesting that person that only for the Christmas Eve you stay there. And that genuine request, now she said this in such a friendly manner, and her manner of speaking was the friendly manner. So what happened because of that, that the rat trap peddler must have felt confidence in her, and because of that, that confidence, it was there. She observed the confidence, and because of that confidence, what happened next? And the next thing happened here, he would start thinking to visit the place. "It would never have occurred to me that you would bother with me yourself, miss," he said. "I will come at once, and surely I will come at once." He accepted the fur coat which the valet handed him with a deep bow, and deep bow means with deep respect, threw it over his rags, and followed the young lady out of the carriage without granting the astonished blacksmith so much as a glance. But while he was riding up to Manor House, he had evil forbidding. And that evil forbidding here, now he was thinking that what will happen. Now he accepted that, and what will happen next? If iron master will understand, then what? And then he started thinking, why the devil did I take that fellow's money? And he again started thinking about the character, that is here Crofter's character, because he had taken the 30 kroners of that Crofter, and he himself now started blaming himself. And what is that? Why the devil did I take that fellow's money? He thought, now I am sitting in the trap, will never get out of it. And now I am sitting in a trap, or now I am trapped, and I may not be come out from the trap, because if I would go there and if they would recognize me, that I am not the Nail Solov, I am not the captain, then they may punish. So here we can observe he started introspecting his own actions, and he started blaming himself, that why I have taken the 30 kroners of that Crofter, and because of my own wrong decision, now I am again trapped in such type of situation. So here in this we can understand. Next, the next day was Christmas Eve, when the Iron Master came in the dining room for breakfast. He probably thought with satisfaction of his old regimental comrade whom he had run across so unexpectedly, and he was very satisfied that the captain or the old acquaintance, friend, regimental comrade, he was there with him for the Christmas Eve. First of all, we must see it that he gets a little flesh on his bones. So here he was very thin, maybe because of the poor condition, maybe because of the poverty. So here this Iron Master is thinking in positive way about that. What is that statement? First of all, we must see to it that he gets a little flesh on his bones, he said with his daughter, who was busy at the table. And then we must see that he gets something else to do than run around the country selling the rat traps. So indirectly here meaning that when he would be here, we have to serve him, we have to give him confidence. And in that confidence, what will happen? His health. He was thinking about the health of the Nail Solov or the old regimental comrade, that his health would be good. And that sort of understanding we are observing in the Iron Master's character, that when your friend is in such a miserable condition and you are thinking about the all atmosphere and trying to think about the positive way, that how that person can go ahead. So this is a sort of thing we can understand. So here up till page number 38 we have discussed remaining part of the story. We will discuss in the next video. Only one important thing you have to do: go through the original story and write in your words whatever the points you will understand, summarized, highlight the points, or you can make the mapping of that story or highlights of the story. You can write the flowchart of the story, you can write. So no more things you have to do, only be positive, think in positive way, and you can complete the story. Whatever I have explained in this part 3, at least that part of the whatever you have listened and whatever you have understood, that make a note of all the important things. Thank you.